Hello students, in the previous video we discussed about chapter 2 of class 10th English, Nelson Mandela Long Walk to Freedom. So this chapter has been divided into three parts by me. I have divided this chapter into three parts in order to explain better. So in the previous video I explained you all up to the address of Nelson Mandela to the students after becoming the president, the first black president of Africa. So he addressed the people, the citizen of Africa, in his address, in his speech, and we have discussed about that address, his words we have discussed. So just after the address, we will start just after the address now. A few moments later, we all lifted our eyes in awe as a spectacular array of South African jets, helicopters and troop carriers roared in perfect formation over the Union buildings. A few moments later, from the pledge, whoever were present there, they all raised their eyes towards the sky in awe. Awe means A-W-E, awe means reverence, respect. So in respect, they raised their eyes towards the sky. And what was happening in the sky? You must have seen the celebration, Independence Day celebration or Republic Day celebration in our India. And you must have seen the jets and aeroplanes moving in the sky over the Red Fort or over the parade ground. Okay, so the same kind of situation was there also. The jets were moving in the sky. The jets were offering their respect to the new president, to the new government. So the same kind of thing was happening there also. The helicopters, jets, African jets, African helicopters and troop carriers, they were offering their tribute to the new government and to the new president. It was not only a display of pinpoint precision and military force, but a demonstration of the military's loyalty to democracy, to a new government that had been freely and fairly elected. And that was not only the tribute, or that was not only the display of pinpoint or precision. Pinpoint means specific thing, or precision means exact or precise thing of military. So it was not the display of military's skills or military's performance. On the other hand, it was the demonstration of military's loyalty towards the new government, towards the nation. Now, only moments before, the highest generals of the South African Defence Force and police, their chests bedecked with ribbons and medals from days gone by, saluted me and pledged their loyalty. A few moments before this demonstration, the generals of army and police, they came to president, to Nelson Mandela. They saluted him, and their chest was decorated with medals and ribbons. You know very well, army officers and police officers, they have some medals and ribbons over their chest on their uniform. So the same kind of ribbons and medals were there on the chest of those officers also. So they saluted him. Now, I was not unmindful of the fact that not so many years before, they would not have saluted but arrested me. Finally, a chevron of Impala jets left a smoke trail of the black, red, green, blue and gold of the new South African flag. Now, Mandela was aware of, not unmindful of means he was aware of. Mandela was aware of the fact that if the same officers, if they had encountered with Mandela earlier, before this, so they would have arrested Mandela and they would not have saluted him. As you know, he was the freedom fighter. So in our country also, those whoever were the freedom fighters, they were the criminal in the contemporary government's eyes. That's why they arrested our freedom fighters also during the freedom struggle. So in the same way, the same thing happened with Mandela and his comrades also. They were also arrested by the by their contemporary government, by their contemporary police force or army. So he is thinking the same after looking at those officers, though they didn't arrest him. But he is thinking, if they had encountered Mandela earlier, so definitely they would have arrested Mandela instead of saluting. So, and just after that, finally, Chevron here means a pattern of V. A V-shaped pattern is known as chevron. So, just after that, a chevron of Impala jets. Impala is the name of those jets. So, those Impala jets left a smoke trail after them. As the jet moves ahead, it leaves the smoke trail behind it. So, those jets left smoke trail of black, red, green, and blue and gold color, and which was the color of South African flag. It was the new South African flag. The day was symbolized for me by the playing of our two national anthems and the vision of whites singing Kosi Sikelel Africa. These are the words of national anthem of white people in Africa. There are two national anthems in Africa. So, for the white people and for the black people, both community had their own or have their own national anthem. So, white people sang this one, Kosi Sikelel Africa, and blacks singing Die Stem. These are the words of national anthem. The old anthem of Republic. So, the black one, the national anthem which was sung by the black people, that was the old national anthem of Republic of that country of Africa. Now, although that day neither group knew the lyrics of the anthem they once despised, they would soon know the words by heart. Both the group, they earlier, before this freedom, before Nelson Mandela became the president, both the groups, they respected their own anthem and they despised the other's anthem. But now, both the community, they sang both the anthems together and with full respect. And Mandela was sure that there would be a day when both the communities will respect and will learn the anthems by heart. Mandela was assured of this thing. Now, on the day of inauguration, I was overwhelmed with a sense of history. In the first decade of the 20th century, a few years after bitter Anglo-Boer War and before my own birth, the white-skinned peoples of South Africa patched up their differences and erected a system of racial domination against the dark-skinned people of their own land. Now, on the day of inauguration, when he became the president, so he was overwhelmed. Overwhelmed means he was filled with emotions. Now see, overwhelming can be of both kind. Overwhelming can be in happiness also, it can be in sadness also, right? It can be in both sadness and happiness. A person can be overwhelmed by sad emotions, a person can be overwhelmed by happy emotions. So here he was filled with sad emotions, both sad and happy emotions. Happy, he was happy because he became the president. He was sad remembering his old past days when he had a kind of suffering. His people suffered a lot. So now he is remembering those days from the history, and it was the first decade of 20th century. First decade, a decade means a period of 10 years. First decade of 20th century means from 901 to 910. So from that period, during that period, after that period, after the bitter Anglo-Boer War. Now, what is this Anglo-Boer War? Anglo-Boer War. Anglo-Boer War means this was the war between African people and the Great Britain. So African people participated in this war for their freedom. Okay, so that was the Anglo-Boer War. Just after this and before Mandela's birth, what was the situation? White-skinned people, they started dominating black-skinned people. Means the domination started before Mandela's birth. Now, means they started discriminating the black people. Now, the structure they created formed the basis of one of the harshest, most inhuman societies the world has ever known. Now, the structure which was created by white people, the racial system which was created by white people, that system created harshest, most human societies in the world. That system created the harshest. Harshest means very hard, harsh, okay, intolerable, and most inhuman. Inhuman means having no human feelings. Okay, so that kind of societies were created by white people's discriminating or racial system. Now, now in the last decade of the 20th century and my own 8th decade as a man, that system had been overturned forever and replaced by one that recognized the rights and freedom of all peoples, regardless of their color of their skin. Now, when it was the last decade of 20th century, means from 1991 to 2000. So during this period, Mandela was already running in his 8th decade, means he had completed 70 years of his age, and now he was running in the 8th decade of his age. So at that time, that old racial system was totally overturned and it was replaced by one system which provided equal rights and freedoms to all the people, without associating with their skin color or with their race, without associating with these things, the system was launched. That day had come about through the unimaginable sacrifices of thousands of my people whose sufferings and courage can never be counted or repaid. And that day, if that day they could bring, if African people could bring that day, so that was the result of thousands of people's sacrifices, thousands of Mandela's comrades' sacrifices, that day came after their sacrifices. They sacrificed their, most of the people sacrificed their lives, and then only they could see that day. And that's why Mandela is saying that their sacrifice cannot be counted, and neither it can be counted nor it can be repaid. One cannot pay for that, right? I felt that day, as I have on so those African patriots, just a minute. I felt that day, as I have on so many other days, that I was simply the sum of all those African patriots who had gone before me. Now, and Mandela is thinking, now after becoming the president, after getting the freedom, Mandela is thinking that he himself was the sum. Means he is thinking that all the people, all his comrades, spirits have been summed up into himself. He is the combination of all those spirits. He is considering himself the combination of all his comrades' spirits. Now, that long and noble line ended now, and now began again with me. I was pained that I was not able to thank them, and that they were not able to see what their sacrifices had wrought. Now Mandela is not happy. He is very sad after becoming president, though he was very happy, but he was not happy for, he was sad for those people, those who have sacrificed their lives for the freedom of their country, and they were not there to see what their sacrifices have wrought, had wrought. Had wrought means achieved or had done. So what their sacrifices had done, those people were not alive to see that thing, एंड नीदर दोज पीपल वर अलाइव टू शेयर दैट थिंग नॉर दोज पीपल वर एबल टू एन्जॉय दैट फ्रीडम. सो एंड इवन मंडेला वॉज नॉट एबल टू थैंक दैम ऑल. सो दैट्स वाई मंडेला वॉज सैड ऑन दैट पर्टिकुलर डे. द पॉलिसी ऑफ अपार्थाइड क्रिएटेड अ डीप एंड लास्टिंग वुंड इन माई कंट्री एंड माई पीपल. ऑल ऑफ अस विल स्पेंड मैनी ईयर्स इफ नॉट जनरेशन रिकवरिंग फ्रॉम दैट प्रोफाउंड हर्ट. Now Mandela says that the apartheid system gave them a deep wound which would not be recovered within a less time. If it would not take generations, then it would take at least few years to recover from that wound. Means that racial system will not be finished so early, it would take some years. Mandela's view was that. Now, but the decades of oppression and brutality had another unintended effect, and that was that it produced the Oliver Tambos, the Walter Sisulus, the Chief Luthulis, the Yusuf Dadus, the Bram Fishers, the Robert Sobukwis of our time. Now, why these all are the names of the people, and you must be knowing that we don't use any article before a proper noun or before a person's name, but here we are using the, because it was Mandela's respect towards his comrade that he is using the before their names. So all these people were created by the oppression and brutality of white people. If they had not made them suffer, then probably these great leaders would not have come up towards the society. Now, so all these men of such extraordinary courage, wisdom and generosity that their like may never be known again. Now Mandela wants to say that these kind of people, those who struggled for freedom, these kind of people will never come in this world again, or will never be born in this world again. Perhaps it requires such depths of oppression to create such heights of character. My country is rich in minerals and gems that lie beneath its soil, but I have always known that its greatest wealth is its people, finer and truer than the purest diamonds. Now, he is saying that perhaps to create Mandela, according to Mandela, if one society wants to create such great leaders in it, then it requires such kind of oppression, then only such kind of characters come in the society, or such kind of characters are born in the society just after the oppression of by other. Now, he is saying that Mandela's country, Africa, is very rich in minerals and gems which are lying under its soils. But he thinks that the country's greatest wealth is its peoples. And he thinks that people are finer and truer than the purest diamonds. They are greater. People of any country are greater than the diamonds. It is from these comrades in the struggle that I learned the meaning of courage. Time and again I have seen men and women risk and give their lives for an idea, and with the help or under the guidance of his comrades, Mandela could learn the meaning of courage and again and again Mandela had seen men and women putting their lives at risk and giving their lives for a single idea of freedom, right? I have seen men stand up to attacks and tortures without breaking, showing a strength and resilience that defies the imagination. Now, Mandela is saying that he had seen people standing up in front of the attacks and tortures and surviving those tortures of white people, and those comrades of Mandela showed great resilience means ability to tolerate the tortures and hardship. So he saw those things into his comrades. Comrades here means companions, right? Sathi. Now, one more thing Mandela learned from his comrades. And what was that? Mandela learned that courage was not the absence of fear, but the triumph over it. One cannot say that if a person is courageous, so he doesn't fear, he doesn't afraid of anything. Fear must be there, but if a person has the quality to overcome that fear, that means he is a brave fellow. Bravery, it's not so that a person who is brave, he has no fear. He has the fear, but he knows the way to overcome that fear. That is called bravery, according to Mandela. No one is born hating another person because of the color of his skin or his background or his religion. In this world, nobody has been born to hate one another or kill one another just because of its his skin or his race. No one has been born in this world for this purpose. People must learn to hate. If they can learn to hate, they can be taught to love, for love comes more naturally to the human heart than its opposite. Now Mandela is saying, you must be thinking, or you will think, that how Mandela can say like this. People must learn to hate, because the persons, those who learn or those who know how to hate, they will learn very easily how to love, because love comes naturally to human heart. So the only that person can learn how to love who knows how to hate. So hatred is also required for learning how to love. Even in the grimmest times in prison, when my comrades and I were pushed to our limits, I would see a glimmer of humanity in one of the guards, perhaps just for a second, but it was enough to rescue me and keep me going. Now Mandela is sharing one of his experience when he was in the prison with his comrades. So what he is saying, that was the grimmest time for them. Grimmest means very difficult and gloomy time for all of them. But even in that grimmest and that gloomy time, he could see a hope of support there in the prison, when all his comrades and he himself were pushed to their limits. Limits means they were pushed to their limits means they were tortured a lot. Even there also, he found a person who had a soft corner in his heart in that prison, and that was one of the guards of that prison. Now, and that thing kept Mandela going ahead. That was the thing that kept that made Mandela to tolerate all those tortures. That was the hope for Mandela. Man's goodness is a flame that can be hidden but never extinguished. Everybody has some goodness in his or her heart. Every human being has some goodness in his or her heart. The need is one has to awake it. The goodness can be there, but it cannot be extinguished. Everybody has the flame of goodness in his heart, and that cannot be extinguished. That cannot be put off. So this was the second part. Thank you very much for listening to me.